This video is for you if you want to learn about immigration pathways to Canada for people over 40 years old. In this video, we are going to be looking at three different immigration pathways for people over 40. So if you're over 40 years old and you want to immigrate to Canada and you've tried express entry, perhaps you are not eligible for express entry, or perhaps you are not meeting the minimum cutoff scores to get an invitation to apply for permanent residence, watch this video. We might have an option for you. Regulated Canadian immigration consultant and owner of Isaac Canada Immigration Consulting, located in Edmonton, Alberta, Canada. We know that for people over 30 years old, the points start to go down in the comprehensive ranking system. You know, every year that passes after age 35, the points gradually decrease, and after age 45 and beyond, you're going to get 0 points for your age in the comprehensive ranking system. So you ask yourself, what are the other options that I have for immigrating to Canada? Let's explore those. There are a couple different options that we are going to be exploring. Number one is studying in Canada and immigrating permanently to Canada through studying. Number two, we're going to be looking at immigrating to Canada through the self-employed person program. Number three, we are going to be looking at Canada's startup visa program. In regards to the first option, studying, there's a few different steps that you need to consider. First step is, number one, you need to gain admission to a college or university in Canada. Number two, you then need to apply for a study permit. The great advantage of a study permit is that if you have a spouse or children, you can also apply for an open work permit for your spouse and study permits for your children. The third step is, after you study, Canada has an amazing program called the Post-Graduation Work Permit Program, which allows students to gain valuable Canadian work experience after they graduate. So I always advise my clients to take at least a 2-year program, because the length of the Post-Graduation Work Permit, which is an open work permit, it's based on the length of time that you study. So if you studied 2 years or longer, you're eligible for up to a 3-year open work permit. After you graduate, you have enough time to gain that valuable Canadian work experience. Next thing that you need to consider is, after you graduate, you get your Canadian work experience, and now you want to immigrate permanently to Canada. So what are your options? In Express Entry, you would actually get extra points for your Canadian education and Canadian work experience, and you could potentially eventually become eligible for Canadian experience class or federal skilled worker after you graduate. The other thing is if your spouse is much younger than you, then if they have the open work permit and they're getting that valuable Canadian work experience, that could also make your family eligible for other immigration options. You need to consider a province that has a very good provincial nominee program, just in case Express Entry doesn't work out for you. We are located in the province of Alberta, and Alberta has a really good program, the Alberta Opportunity Stream, and for people who graduate from an eligible school and an eligible program and they apply for permanent residence, you can do so after 6 months of working full-time under your post-graduation work permit. But you and your family could potentially be permanent residents a year, 2 years after graduation. So that is a pathway towards permanent residency, or at least to give you Canadian education and work experience for you and your family. The second option to consider is the self-employed category. The Self-Employed Persons Program allows people to immigrate permanently to Canada as a self-employed person. To be eligible under this program, you must have relevant experience in cultural activities or athletics, and you must be willing to make a significant contribution to the cultural or athletic life of Canada. You're probably wondering to yourself, what does significant contribution, what does cultural activities, what do athletic activities mean? Let's get into it. For cultural activities, these could be activities such as, maybe you're an author, a journalist, a writer, perhaps you're an artist, You could be a craftsperson, like a glass blower or a potter or a silversmith, a metal arts worker, a sculptor, a musician, a performing artist, a graphic artist and designer, creative designer, motion picture, technical support, and related jobs. So that's just an idea to give you some of the different experience that you could have and be eligible for this program. In terms of eligibility, relevant experience includes the following. You've been self-employed in cultural activities or athletics, or you've taken part in cultural activities or athletics at a world-class level. This experience must be during the last 5 years before the day you apply and ending in the day IRCC makes a decision on your application. In terms of minimum experience for athletes, you need 2 1-year periods being self-employed in athletics or 2 1-year periods participating at a world-class level in athletics, or it could be a combination of 1 year period being self-employed in athletics, and a 1 year period participating in world-class athletics. In terms of the minimum experience required for cultural activities, you need 2 1-year periods of being self-employed in cultural activities or 2 year periods of participating in world-class level in cultural activities, or a combination of 1 year period in cultural activities and a 1 year period participating at a world-class level in cultural activities. Other selection criteria such as age and education and language and adaptability are also considered in the selection criteria. And just remember, if you are taking an IELTS test, make sure it's the general test. And the benefit of this program is that you and your family come direct as permanent residents. So it's an amazing program. If you look at it, you can come to Canada and study for 2 years and then apply for a post-graduation work permit and then eventually apply for permanent residency. But if you're eligible under the self-employed category, then you would basically just wait for your application to be processed and then come to Canada direct as a permanent resident. So this is a great option. The third option I want to talk to you about today is Canada's Startup Visa. Canada's Startup Visa program is a program for entrepreneurs who have the skills and ability to build businesses in Canada that are innovative, can create jobs for Canadians, and can compete on a global scale. In terms of requirements, your business idea or venture must get the support, including a letter of support from a designated organization, such as venture capital funds, angel investor groups, and business incubator. You, as an entrepreneur, you must actively engage in your business from the start inside of Canada. Therefore, it's recommended that you apply for a temporary work permit in order to begin the incubation period inside of Canada. The great thing about this program is that you do not need to have high English language proficiency requirements. So the minimum that you need is only a CLB5. So for many of you, this will be a very accessible program. Additionally, you must prove that you have sufficient funds to cover you and your family members for the first year in Canada. In terms of a qualifying business, it means that your business meets the following requirements. At the time you get a commitment from a designated organization, each applicant holds 10% or more of the voting rights attached to all shares of the corporation. This means that up to 5 people can apply as owners. So if you are working with another business partner, or if you and several other people that you know want to group together on this, then this is a great opportunity. And at the time you receive your permanent residence, you provide active and ongoing management of the business from within Canada. The benefits of this program is unconditional permanent residence, a pathway to the Canadian passport, one of the most highly sought after and valuable citizenships to have in the world. Great thing about becoming a permanent resident is that you have access to everything that Canadians have, such as the education system and world-class healthcare, and the only thing that you won't have is voting rights. I hope you enjoy the summary of 3 options that you can choose if you're over 40 years old. Remember, you can choose to study in Canada and invest that way. Invest your time and energy in your education and Canadian work experience, The other option is the self-employed persons category. If you have, if you meet the requirements in terms of experience in cultural activities and athletics at the world-class level, or consider looking at Canada's Startup Visa Program. Again, this is a great program, and you can partner with a few other individuals, up to five people, and it's a great opportunity for permanent residents. So if you'd like to learn more about these programs, please send us an email, or you can book an appointment with myself. Additionally, if you've immigrated to Canada through one of these pathways, leave your comments below. I would like to hear about that. And if you have any questions, or if you would like to give your feedback regarding other recommendations that you have for us to make videos on, please put your comments below. I look forward to hearing from you. Okay, everybody, have a great day.